Here with me now to talk about efforts to create political costs for the impeachment vote, Ezra Levin, co-founder of Indivisible, a political action group whose latest initiative, Payback Project, is aimed at defeating the Senate Republicans who helped Donald Trump escape removal from office. Ezra, welcome. What is this project?
Look, what we learned today is that Donald Trump is a bulbous bile-spewing symptom of a much deeper problem with our democracy. What we see is that it's not just Trump. When he's gone, when we defeat him in November, we won't suddenly have saved democracy. Mitch McConnell, the Senate Majority Leader on the Republican side, has called voting rights and election security on the floor of the U.S. Senate socialism and a power grab. He's promised in his own words to be the grim reaper of all progressive legislation. And today, what we have seen is senators on his side of the aisle standing with Donald Trump instead of the Constitution. So this payback project is about exactly what it sounds like. It's about payback. It's about ensuring that we flip these 9 Senate seats so that the incoming president in 2021 has a Democratic Senate and a pro-democracy Senate.
Sarah Gideon, I believe, is the challenger up in Maine against Susan Collins. She's been fundraising fairly well. It is striking to me. I mean, Collins knows that state well. She's been popular there. It is striking to me how much her approval rating has declined in the wake, particularly of the Kavanaugh vote.
That's right. So what we see happening all across the country, it's in Maine, it's in Colorado, it's in Iowa, it's in Arizona, is this isn't an effort that's going to get up and go a week before the election to get out the vote. The way that you win these seats is by actively getting engaged on the ground and making clear to folks in that state, hey, this senator doesn't actually represent us. This senator is one of the problems in the Senate, and we got to get rid of him. And so we saw that in Maine going all the way back to 2017 when Mainers were out in front of her offices saying, hey, vote against this tax bill. Hey, vote against Kavanaugh. And when she didn't, all the folks in their communities saw that. We saw that exact phenomenon play out in Colorado with Cory Gardner, in Arizona with Martha McSally, and we're seeing it more across the country in these states as it pertains to this vote on impeachment.
Yeah, so the theory of the case here, right, of what I'm hearing is that you can't just run ads late in the campaign. You have to sort of organize around and increase the salience of these big key votes when they're happening and right after they're happening.
Yeah, there's this common misconception that elections are won on election day, and nothing could be further from the truth. Elections begin the day after election day. Then you start building. We launched the paybackproject.org website 3 or 4 days ago. We've had 25,000 volunteers sign up. We had our first training tonight and hit capacity on the training. Now, these volunteers, what are they going to be doing? Many of them don't live in these states. What they're going to be doing is texting in to these states to recruit volunteers. So we're recruiting Arizonans, we're recruiting Coloradans, we're recruiting Iowans, we're recruiting Mainers in those states, people with legitimacy, people who not only are going to have to choose whether or not to vote for a Susan Collins or vote for a Cory Gardner, but they're going to be the ones that can mobilize their communities in a few months to actually get them out of office. That's the stage of the fight we're in right now.
All right. Ezra Levin from Indivisible. Thanks so much for sharing that. Appreciate it.
Thanks for having me.